brought to you by the city-friendly Toyota Prius C. Welcome to Car Designer Talk, where we ask a real car designer the questions you've always been embarrassed to ask because they're just not good questions.
They're bad questions. I'm Streeter.
And I own three of these.
No, you don't.
I don't, but I'm Pat, and we're here with Stuart Reed from the Transportation Design Department at the Art Center College of Design in Pasadena.
Stuart, let me just start off with the question on everyone's mind. Are cars going to drive themselves soon?
They already are.
Like, for real, though. I mean, like,
yeah,
I just
not,
get in and
not
I
like
go,
some Google, like, labs thing.
Yeah, yeah.
No, but I mean, they are. We've had a car run up Pikes Peak at speed, you know, a race right at the edge of the mountain.
With no driver.
With no driver.
Is anyone working on doing away with tires? Like, I'm not saying flying cars, but, like, has any, you know, are you guys looking at, like, alternatives to round tires?
Well, I mean, if you think about it, you know, when a tire is operating, it isn't round.
Oh, my God. Here he goes again.
Right?
You're like,
no, because I mean, you want this contact patch with.
You're like the Riddler.
No, you want this contact patch on the surface, and so as it comes around, you need a flat area.
Yeah.
And so what the ground sees, it's not actually moving. It's motionless on the ground,
well,
right?
At that point,
think about it.
I'm not.
And so you
right.
want a good contact patch. So.
So what shape are tires?
Well, if you look at it in front view, most tires actually are much more rectangular cross section in front view.
Assuming you had an infinite budget, could you build a car that transformed into a robot?
If you take the technology of a robot that can do all of these things and make judgments and process things and be a complex machine, a car is already way past that.
You're missing the, like, you're missing the crucial
you'd be like the
word
worst,
there.
You'd be like the worst person on like Christmas morning. You'd be like, well, a fern is a lot like the ultimate action figure. Every day's an adventure for it.
So the Prius C, it's like, oh, it's the newest member of the Prius family. They always talk about families.
Is there like one family of cars that's like no one wants to be around?
Yeah. The Clampets of the, of the car world.
A brand becomes kind of a precious thing. An automaker has invested so much in bringing it to the point that it is. But when the Prius came on the scene, it was a decidedly new statement. It was a new kind of a silhouette. You want it to, in some way, look different without being really weird or strange. You know, they've done an amazing job of doing something that has identified a new category of vehicle as different from others.
How did the glove box or glove compartment get its name?
From gloves. Actually, if you go back to the very earliest...
You know who was the first person to wear gloves in
the
car,
don't you? Not that so much, but...
Kind of the first person to wear gloves.
But the first motor cars were actually motorized carriages. You had to virtually be a strong mechanic to operate a motor vehicle, and so you needed these large leather, almost gauntlets. They were big boxes, wood boxes that you put sets of gloves in.
I gotta be honest with you here. That was a joke question, and you actually knew, like, there's actually a real answer. And now I feel even stupider. That's all the time we have for Car Designer Talk. I'd like to thank our guest, Stuart Reed. I'm Streeter.
I'm Pat, and I just also wanted to run this by you. Triangular wheels, I think, could be a thing. I don't know if you got to maybe run that
Why?
By your guys. Because they're like, out of triangles, like, no one's ever done triangle wheels.
Presumably for a reason.
Yeah, because they're not forward. I mean, because
they wouldn't work.
He's not saying it's a bad idea.
Also, you can't make a triangle wheel. A wheel's a circle.
That's true. Okay.